Welcome back to Let's Play Freddy Pharkas Frontier Pharmacist. Take 3, because this game hates me. It's not really the game, it's the recording. It's Hypercam being a jerk. Before, the first take, instead of recording the game audio, we recorded a microphone that's plugged into my computer that it wasn't supposed to record, because I'm using a laptop to record this, because Hypercam's a pain in the butt. And the last recording, it's like, oh, I shut off sequential numbers to the record part, so instead of having, you know, these 3 parts that I put together, it wrote over the same part over and over again, so I lost the whole, like, beginning 3/4 of the part, so grumble. I do have a new headset for the main LP, but the thing is I need a extension thing for the jack. Otherwise, I can't plug it into 2 places at once, because it's not one of the ones where you can just, you know, separate it. Yeah. Anyways, enough of that. Now that I've wasted a minute and a quarter just talking about that, which really doesn't matter, let's go to the west, and we don't know what to do at this point. I do know, because I had it figured out once, and I did it twice already. But if we look at Chester right here, lost his best friend, will polish ears for stagecoach fare, which is a little bit strange. I mean, the only person who would possibly get their ears polished would be Freddy right now, because he has that one silver ear. Basically what is happening right now is there is well, let's just talk to him and I'll show it. It explains it a lot better. Down on your luck, silver disguised strangers. Best gull. Gull? Okay. And, yeah, right now, everybody in Coarse Gold is losing their property to a guy in the saloon playing poker. And this guy had a queen high straight flush. That is a damn good hand. There's not too many hands that beat that, but the guy got a king high flush. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to actually play poker versus the guy, which is a little unfortunate. But this is our first little sub-mission of Act 4. Being the last act of the game, there's only so many parts left of this. Also, as soon as it comes up, you'll notice that I'm not too far away from maxing out the score, minus the points that I don't have because of the snails. Anyway, if we talk over here, there's a little semi-cameo. This guy is actually the ancestor of Leisure. I've recorded this 3 times, and I've had problems saying Leisure the first time, all 3 times. RPG, what are you going to do with yourself one of these days? One of these days I am going to learn how to talk. But this is Leisure Suit Larry's ancestor, another game from Sierra. I've never actually played those, though. Oh, also another interesting thing, apparently point-and-clicks are coming back, because I saw a Back to the Future point-and-click game that was released on one of those, was it PlayStation Stream? On the Xbox? Something like that. I was looking at it and I'm like, this is a new point and click! Yay! I was happy! Anyways, let's talk to the people playing poker with aces. Say it ain't so, Joe! Joe grunts. That's most you've ever heard him say. This is aces. This guy in the black, obviously, because, you know, he's evil and everybody else doesn't look evil. Hey, Cooper, don't do it, you lose everything! He ignores you, you're spoiling his lack of concentration. Ollie, listen to me, don't do it, it's not worth it! Don't waste your breath. And this is Muff. I don't know where he got the name Muff. If his parents gave him to him, I don't know what's wrong with his parents. Muff's never been too bright. But we're not going to actually play poker. What we need to do is watch. Now, in a little bit, there is going to be something happening on the screen. Oh, see that? Hand. Now, if we look at aces, he's holding his cards tightly. One of his hands appears unusually stiff. Maybe he's nervous. No, maybe one of his hands is fake. Now, hopefully, we can catch this guy. I think if we just use the glasses, it doesn't really help us. As soon as it comes back up, of course. Come on. Come on, aces. It appears to be a third hand, so that's how he's cheating. Need to use the hand to grab his hand. Once the hand comes up. Come on, aces. There we go. You're cheating. That's a fake left hand. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, yes, silver-haired-eared stranger. You're correct. Almost. As you see, I have no cards in my left hand. I only have this. Why did I give a bad guy a good guy name? Like, voiceover. Why am I voice acting at all? I'm not being consistent with it. I'm just doing it randomly. Nah. Also, from my view, one of his hand, the hand holding the gun seemed smaller than the other ones. I don't know why. But yes, we're going to save right here, because there is quite a few... Why do you keep going up that high? Stop that. That's what keeps making Freddy go at warp speed. For some reason, But what we're supposed to do, once it saves, of course, is use Freddy's guns and somehow shoot this guy. Now, if we go the direct route... Yeah, Freddy's skills are not up to snuff. So, but what we need to do is do a trick shot. You know, the whole cartoony shot of it bouncing all over the room. That's what we need to do. There's several spots where we can start that, and some of them don't exactly give wonderful consequences. If we shoot this one, it bounces over there, and kills that poor woman. Be kind, please rewind. And this is probably the silliest gag in the game. Just randomly, it's all like, okay, we're going to rewind the game for you. You killed someone in the town, but yeah, that's fine. We can shoot over here. And this, ping over there, and kill Larry's ancestor. There might be some other places you can shoot in the room, and other people that die, but I don't know where those are. Maybe I can shoot the bottles. She exploded! The sheep lady exploded! Alright, now I'm gonna spend some time shooting random things. Oh! Let's see, what else can I shoot? No, I guess if I shoot it on that side, it ends up killing Freddy. Alright, so what we're actually supposed to do is shoot the bar rail right behind... Is that what it's called? The bar rail? Well, that's what it looks like. That's what it should be called. That bounces over there, hits the chandelier, and captures the guy quite nicely. Yeehaw! And I just skipped a block of text, I'm sorry. Oh, brouhaha. Again, well, for the 9th time that I've said this now, oh, that's how you spell it. there's some things you just need to repeat. Now, let's save again. I know it's a little bit soon, but, really? Really? Annoyances! Anyway, save. Now, if we try to go outside... Without warning, you hear gunshots in front of... Gunshots? What? that's our warning not to walk out there, but we're going to do that anyway, since we saved and we're playing a game. There's a bunch of people out here. Mr. Purple, this guy, that guy, and the guy with the trench coat. Having quite the old time of shooting around the town. Frightening, not to mention killing, the locals. Let's stampede the women and rape the cattle. Right. And Freddy, being the absolute moron that he is, walks right into the line of fire and gets himself killed. Huh. As you probably remember, there is a back door, thank goodness, otherwise we would never get out of here. What we're supposed to do, if that there is a spot where you're supposed to talk to, or you might talk to the, or look at, or whatever, the barber, who is also the dentist. He has a canister of nitrous oxide, which is what we're after. He also would have mentioned something about giving his clients something to look at. Well, we have those French postcards, which will probably work quite nicely. So let's give those to him. They may not be able to read, but I'm sure they're going to enjoy their porn. Wait a minute, what in the hell are those girls doing? It's not legal on this side of the Sierra Nevada. Nah. Free shave? No, I'm the hero. We don't grow beards. Nope, took that out. College for extra money for tuition. That sounds like fun. I am so glad I've gotten my wisdom teeth removed and never have to worry about it again. Nitrous oxide. Now, if you're familiar with the effects of nitrous oxide, it makes you kind of not care about anything. It's also known as laughing gas, which is basically the application that we're going to use it for. How one little tiny canister would work on a full-size street, that was rather gruesome and unpleasant. Anyway, how one little canister would work on an entire street, because this, they're not only there, they are east of here also. I think where the assay office is and where Bank of Bob is, those two screens are safe. Everywhere in between has these guys. Thankfully, being up here, they don't see us. And we can place the nitrous oxide canister right here. Now, we do not want to get affected by this nitrous oxide, so we actually have to go somewhere else. And we are going to use our guns to shoot it. I don't think you can shoot it from up on the railing. It's possible. I doubt it. But the place we're supposed to go is actually the whorehouse. You might have not noticed it. I didn't notice it the first time either. But if you look on up here, you can see it. And since this part has gotten shorter and shorter after this, the first time I recorded this part, I was right here at 16 minutes, because at one part I didn't know what I was doing, and then the second time I was right at 15 minutes, now I'm at about 14. So I keep shaving time off. Anyway, what we're going to do is use our guns to shoot that. Don't have a straight shot from... Alright, so I need to stand somewhere different. Slowly squeeze off a shot. You did it. You shot off the canister's valve. Now, I don't know much about nitrous oxide, but I really don't think that that one... Well, those guys might have been affected. I don't really know if the rest of the guys on the street would have been affected. It just doesn't make sense to me. I don't know. I would think it would be... diffused a little bit more with all the air, especially if there's a slight breeze. I mean, that wouldn't have worked. But anyway, it's a game. Stop talking about real-world mechanics, RPG. You should know better than that. Some big guns from down south? What? But you'll find out who that is next time. Hopefully this time, this part comes out okay, because I'm sick of recording it at the moment. This game is fun, this game is amusing, but recording the same 15 minutes is rather annoying. But yes, next time, more of Chapter 4, which is, again, the last chapter, so there's not too much left of this game. So, next time, more of this. Until then. I hope this comes out alright.